Jesus is not an attorney. There is no meter running. Time is precious. So, as a rabbi, he tells a little story about a man with barns that are filled to capacity who had also a bad heartbeat. In Jesus' parable, the landowner's faith is pure vanity because it is in himself. He is a self-made man, and he knows it. There is no unusual uncertainty here. Listen to him speak. What shall I do? I will do this. I will pull down my barns and build larger ones. And there I will store up all my grain and my goods. It's a litany of all he has done and will do, but it's a chorus sung only in praise of himself. This is what I have done, and this is what I will do to take care of myself. There is no mention of his family, his neighbors, and certainly not God. Frankly, why would this man even think he needed God? He was prosperous. He was healthy. He could get by on his own, thank you very much. No, he had no need for faith in God when he could have faith in himself. Our society tells us that too, doesn't it? Believe in yourself. Be your own person. The landowner's first article of faith is in himself, and his second is like unto it. It is in his possessions. And I will say to my soul, soul, you have ample goods laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, and be merry. Did you hear that? There is such a subtle shift in language here that most of us miss it. Soul is not an economic term. Look through the indexes in the books of Milton Friedman and John Kenneth Galbraith and Adam Smith and John Maynard Keynes, and you won't find the word soul listed. Soul is a theological term. And Jesus' point is that if we ever confuse the two, we are in trouble. At funerals here at St. John's, we don't sing, it is well with my bank book. But rather we sing, it is well with my soul. The soul is the part of us where we relate to God and to others. Yet all of us have known people who have sold their very souls to make that extra buck. The man who devoted more and more of himself to his career and his year-end bonus and barely noticed that his family and his friends were slowly, slowly drifting away. All of us have known people who violated the life commandment that my Uncle Herb gave me as a child, which is in fact the point of today's parable. People are more important than things. Neither the poet of the Old Testament nor the landowner in the New Testament realized this, and so, in the end, they choose to be fools, living out a life of vanity. Sometimes financial crises cause us to have a moment of realized vanity where we discover not only what is important in our lives, but who is the only one that can get us through the tough times. Jesus isn't calling us to give up our 401ks, our stocks, our houses, or our cars. He's just reminding us that they must not be the objects of our faith, the deepest desires of our hearts. That place belongs to God, who has been abundantly rich and gracious toward us. If we place our faith in God, and not in ourselves or our possessions, no matter what our balance sheets look like, whether they be filled with red or black ink, we will still have everything we need. We'll have the power of God by our side that lasts from now until eternity. And this power will see us through, because it offers us everything and more than everything we really need. It comes in the love and the power and the sustaining presence of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.